talk about the measurement of voltage standing wave ratio. Now, when it comes to the voltage standing wave ratio, we must understand what do you mean by voltage standing waves. So whenever you are terminating your circuit with a mismatched load, what will happen? The reflections will be there, and that reflections may lead, or that reflections will leads to the standing waves, and that standing waves forms inside that transmission line. So how you're going to talk about the ratio of this standing waves? It will be called as the voltage standing wave ratio. So voltage standing wave ratio is the ratio of V maxima by V minima, and which can be calculated 1 plus reflection coefficient mod of and 1 minus mod of reflection coefficient. So reflection coefficient is reflected power divided by incident power. In terms of the load, you can calculate it as a ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. Both formulas are same. So your voltage standing wave ratio varies from 1 to infinity, whereas your reflection coefficient varies from 0 to 1. Because if you see here, the maximum limit can be 1 only for the reflection coefficient. So if you see, because of your incident and because of your reflected waves, these waves are formed inside the transmission line. And whatever transmission line we are having is nothing but the waveguide. So you are having a maximum voltage, which will be called as a V maxima, and this is the minimum voltage, which will be called as the V minimum. So, and this complete, this is half of this, and this complete will be called as the guide wavelength, wavelength inside the waveguide. So this will be called as the guide wavelength. So if I'm talking in terms of the guide wavelength, and if I'm interested in the guide wavelength, I can say this is nothing but the 2 into, if I measure 2 successive minimas, to mera guide wavelength kya hoga? 2 into distance between 2 successive minimas. In other way, I can calculate lambda g is equal to 2 into distance between 2 successive maximas. Just take care that you are taking 2 successive maximas and 2 successive minimas. If I talk in terms of the maximas and minimas, it will be 4. Or now you see, this is the minima and this is the maxima. So this will be the 4 into, I can say, distance between 2 successive minima and maxima. Okay, so this, if the 2 successive minimas are given, you can calculate the lambda g. If minimas and maximas are given, again you need to multiply it with the 4. So this is how you're going to calculate the lambda g, that is guide wavelength. Because we are going to talk about the guide wavelength in, or we are going to talk about the voltage standing wave ratio in terms of the guide wavelength, that's why you need to know how that guide wavelength can be calculated. So the first thing which we'll talk about is nothing but the measurement of low voltage standing wave ratio. Now here, to measure the low voltage standing wave ratio, we must know the setup which we are using. So adjusting attenuator to give an adequate reading on the meter. So you are having a microwave source here. If you see here, you are having a microwave source. This is the pad. This is the slotted line. This will be the load. This will be the crystal detector, and this is nothing but the DC voltmeter or millivoltmeter. Now you are doing probe of the slotted line. This slotted line probe is like, you can move that probe. You can move it to get the maximum reading where the attenuation is adjusted to get the full meter reading. So do one thing. You just move that probe where you are getting the maximum reading, and you adjust that particular reading to get a full meter reading and note it down. Take care. The next thing, then the probe of the slotted line is moved along with the minimum reading, and the ratio of max to min reading is taken. So the full scale deflection corresponds to the voltage standing wave ratio of 1. So this is the simple method how you're going to measure the low voltage standing wave ratio if your standing wave ratio is less than 10. But when it comes to the voltage standing wave ratio, which is greater than 10, then the full scale deflection will be, or that covering that complete range will be difficult. So in this case, we are using another method, which will be called as the double minimum method. So we'll see how the double minimum method gives you the voltage standing wave ratio measurement. So in the double minimum method, we are not going to measure the V maximas and V minimas, but here we are going to measure what? We're going to measure here 2 half power points. Okay? So jo bhi aapke half power points hai. So if you'll see here, when I talk in terms of the power points, what happens when I talk in terms of the power point? Half power point, when I talk in terms of the dBs, 3 dB down. When I talk in terms of the voltage, it is 2 root minimum. So if I find where I am getting root 2 minimum values. This will be the 2 half power points. So I'll just measure the distance between 2 half power points. Now I'm going to apply an empirical formula over here. Whereas I know how I am going to find out voltage standing wave ratio is nothing but the 1 by theta. Now what is the theta? It's theta is equal to omega t. Now what is the omega? Omega is 2 pi f. If I put all these values here, my theta will become 2 pi f t. ठीक है? Now I know that frequency is equal to c by lambda. But as we are talking inside the waveguide, it will be lambda g. So if I put that value here, this will be 2 pi c divided by lambda g t. Then my theta here will become 2 pi by lambda g. Now I'm just separating out this term c into t. Now I'm again writing these things on the new slide. So you'll understand what I'm doing here. ठीक है? So theta is equal to, as I can already talked about, this will be 2 pi by lambda g c into t. Now you know that c into t, c is the velocity, t is the length. So in our case, this will be the distance, which is nothing but the d, I can say distance between that particular. So I can write here, this distance is nothing but the delta x. So I'll just write ct is nothing but the delta x. Velocity into time is equal to distance. So I can say this delta x is the distance from v mean to root v mean. ठीक है? सो अगर आप ये, इफ यू सी दिस पर्टिकुलर, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ये आपका v mean है. सो आई कैन से दिस पर्टिकुलर विल बी द डेल्टा एक्स. ठीक है? सो इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द डेल्टा एक्स, सो दिस विल बी 2 पाई बाय लैम्डा जी. नाउ आई एम नॉट एट ऑल एबल टू कमेंट ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर डिस्टेंस बिकॉज, बट आई कैन से दैट दिस डी वन माइनस डी टू बाई हाफ विल बी डेल्टा एक्स बिकॉज दिस इज एग्जैक्टली एट द सेंटर. सो इफ आई नीड टू पुट दैट थिंग्स ओवर देयर, आई जस्ट पुट दिस डी टू माइनस डी वन डिवाइडेड बाई टू इज नथिंग बट द डेल्टा एक्स. ठीक है? सो हियर थीटा विल बिकम, टू टू विल गेट कैंसिल, दिस विल बी पाई डी टू माइनस डी वन डिवाइडेड बाई लैमडा जी. एंड एज वी नो दैट माई बी एस डब्ल्यू आर इज इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन थीटा, आई कैन से माई बी एस डब्ल्यू आर विद दिस एम्पिरिकल मेथड लैमडा जी डिवाइडेड बाई पाई डी टू माइनस डी वन. सो इफ यू नो वॉट इज द गाइड वेवलेंथ, इफ यू नो वॉट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू हाफ पावर पॉइंट्स, ठीक है, यू कैन वेरी वेल कमेंट ऑन द वोल्टेज स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशियो. एंड दैट्स वाई इट्स वेरी मच नीडेड टू अंडरस्टैंड वट इज द गाइड वेव लेंथ. सो दिस इज द मेथड विच यू कैन अप्लाई टू फाइंड आउट इफ योर वोल्टेज स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशियोज आर ग्रेटर दैन 10. सो हियर वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड हाउ वी कैन मीजर द वोल्टेज स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशियोज फॉर द लोअर वैल्यूज एंड फॉर द हायर वैल्यूज. सो फॉर द लोअर वैल्यूज अ वेरी सिंपल मेथड, विद द माइक्रोवेव बेंच सेटअप यू कैन फाइंड आउट वोल्टेज स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशियो. एंड फॉर वेरी हायर वैल्यूज यू कैन गो फॉर द डबल मिनिमम मेथड. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द वोल्टेज स्टैंडिंग वेव रेशियो मेजरमेंट.